Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the VXLAN Anycast RP Multicast Underlay solution. If you like my content so far, and if you're interested in seeing more networking and telecom technologies simply explained, then please subscribe now to the channel. And when you subscribe, make sure to enable notifications like so, so that you'll be informed of new content. If you like this video, make sure to click that thumbs up button. In some previous videos, we went over the logic behind the operation of a multicast underlay for VXLAN. And we took a look at how this can be configured on some Cisco Nexus switches. Now, this multicast solution works. However, there are some issues that you must be aware of. In this video, we'll be highlighting the weaknesses of the multicast solution we discussed in our previous videos, and we'll be explaining how to deploy a more robust and appropriate multicast underlay using an Anycast Rendezvous Point, or Anycast RP. Now, it's important to note here that these issues have more to do with how multicast is deployed rather than how VXLAN operates. For this reason, it's necessary to have a good grasp of multicast, including things like PIM sparse mode, rendezvous points, as well as Anycast IP addressing. Now, I don't yet have a series on multicast, but that's coming soon. In the meantime, if you need to brush up on your multicast, do so before you continue with this video. Now, this is the topology that we used in our deployment of a multicast underlay for VXLAN. Now, when you use multicast for the VXLAN underlay, it's best to use sparse mode rather than dense mode for various reasons. Without going too much into detail, sparse mode is more scalable, more efficient, has a reduced network load, and is thus ideal for high performance, high throughput data center and cloud deployments. You would never consider dense mode for such networks. Now, PIM sparse mode uses what is known as a rendezvous point, or an RP. This is a designated device on the network that acts as a common point of contact for multicast receivers and sources. In the case of VXLAN, the leaf devices, or the VTEPs, are those multicast sources and receivers. It is the VTEPs that communicate using multicast. An RP helps in efficiently managing multicast group memberships and multicast routing by serving as the root of what is known as a shared tree, or the RP tree, to which multicast sources send their traffic and from which receivers join the multicast group. The RP is a vital part of the operation of PIM sparse mode multicast. So the first weakness in our original multicast solution is that we only have one RP. It's a single point of failure. Now, although we didn't show it in our multicast configuration, we had actually manually configured that RP, and we statically configured each of the other routing devices in the underlay network to point to that device as the RP. Now, this is troublesome because that RP, as I mentioned before, is indeed a single point of failure. And if it does fail, you have to go in and manually reconfigure all the devices in the underlay network to point to another device as the new RP. And if you don't have an active RP in your network, multicast will not work. And that's a big problem for VXLAN. Now, there are several solutions that will provide us with dynamic redundancy to our RP. There are a couple of RP discovery protocols that can automatically and dynamically detect an alternative RP in the event that the original RP fails. For example, you can use Cisco's proprietary auto RP solution, or you can use the Multicast PIM Bootstrap Protocol, or BSR. The latter is an open standard supported by multiple vendors. Both of these protocols provide this dynamic discovery and automatic backup of RPs in the event of a failure. Now, although these solutions are good, they are inadequate for use within a data center or a cloud infrastructure because their failover processes are too slow, and that would result in unacceptable outages. So these solutions are out. The most appropriate approach for VXLAN when using multicast is to use an Anycast RP solution. Anycast RP is a technique used in PIM sparse mode to provide redundancy and load balancing for the rendezvous point. In this configuration, multiple RPs are configured with the same IP address. Yes, that's right, the same IP address. This address is known as the Anycast IP address that's assigned to the RP. These RPs are typically spread across different locations within the network. When a multicast source sends its data to the Anycast RP address, the underlying routing protocol, such as EIGRP or OSPF or whatever else is used, will direct the traffic to the nearest RP. Nearest simply means the RP that has the smallest distance or routing protocol metric to the source. Similarly, multicast receivers also join the multicast group via the nearest RP. If one RP fails, the routing protocol dynamically redirects the traffic to the other operational RP almost instantaneously, ensuring continuous availability and improved reliability. The setup enhances scalability and fault tolerance in large multicast networks, something that is required in data center and cloud-based VXLAN topologies. But there's one additional issue with all of this. Until now, in my diagrams, we only have a single uplink from each leaf switch. But typically, in such networks, you will have two or more uplinks to two or more spine switches. That means that for any particular leaf switch, either uplink can be used. Now, how does a VTEP choose which uplink to use to send multicast traffic? Well, in such a case, leaf switches will use a hashing algorithm to choose which uplink to use. This hashing algorithm is designed to more evenly distribute multicast traffic. But that means that we may end up sending multicast traffic via either uplink, and one uplink may be closer, in terms of routing metric, to a different RP. This can result in inconsistent RP trees and multicast routing. There's one final step to resolve this issue in our multicast underlay solution. We must give the multiple RPs a way to share information. So even if this happens, they can still synchronize their information between them. So if some leaves join one RP and others join another RP, there must be a way to allow these RPs to synchronize to each other. That way, if one RP fails, the other will already have all the up-to-date information for all multicast groups. There are a couple of ways actually to achieve this synchronization. One is to use PIM itself. The RPs can be configured to exchange PIM messages between all spine switches configured as RPs so that they can all learn about the multicast sources and all the multicast receivers. Alternatively, you can use what is known as Multicast Source Discovery Protocol, or MSDP. Both of these are viable solutions for VXLAN. So if you're going to create a robust, reliable, and redundant multicast underlay for a VXLAN topology, the best solution is to deploy PIM sparse mode with multiple RPs using Anycast IPs in order to eliminate the single point of failure that one RP introduces. You can then use either PIM or MSDP to synchronize between those RPs. Now, all of this can be done to minimize downtime in the event of a failure, and to resolve the inconsistencies that can be introduced by the redundant uplinks on the VTEPs. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.